In the name of Jesus Christ, God bless you. This is Dr. Gabe Ezobele. Once again here, I'm very happy to be with you and all the series that God has been giving us today. We are going to talk about something very interesting, and I know that God has been reaching you since we began to pray. Amen. In the name of Jesus Christ, Labrogo Shekerebalika ta. I want us to pray this hour. Father, the Bible says the entrance of the word bringeth light and understanding to the simple. Lord, your word is a lamp unto our feet and a light unto our path. Let the word that we shall hear and speak now not be an enticing word of a man, but let it be the word of God that will bring glory to thy holy name. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. The word for us today is the keys of the kingdom. I'm just going to break it down because of our time. I know that your time is very precious and you are very busy. And many of you in Africa that are following me say you need little, you know, clips so that your data can carry it. Those of you in Asia also, and some of you in Europe. But by the grace of God, we are going to cover this, the keys of the kingdom. If you have not begun to follow us, begin to follow us on YouTube. We are Bishop Gabe on YouTube. On Facebook, Dr. Gabe Ezobele. On Instagram, Dr. Gabe Ezobele. Subscribe to my channel on YouTube. God will bless you in the name of Jesus. And you will be getting all our materials as it comes. The keys of the kingdom. The keys of the kingdom. What is the keys of the kingdom? They are keys to everything in life. And if you have the right key on the wrong door, it will not open. And if you have the wrong key on the right door, it will not open also. So you have to have the right key. So Jesus said there are keys. So we know that there are many keys. But there are few keys that I've brought out today for us to understand. And if you look at the book of Matthew 16, if you read from verse 13, the Bible says, and Jesus took them to Caesar Philippi in verse 13 of Matthew 16. And they came there. And that, I don't know why he chose that place, but this is where demons and all the negative powers operate. And he decided to tell them who he was there. And the Bible says he looked at them and said, who do men say that I am? And they began to say, some say you are prophet Elijah, some say you are Jeremiah, you are one of the prophets and all that, John the Baptist. But the Bible says Jesus looked at them and said, who do you think that I am? Who do you say that I am? And everybody was quiet, but Peter, being the kind of person he was, you know, he liked to say what comes into his mind. The Spirit of God ministered to him. He jumped up and Peter said, you are Christ, the Son of the living God. And Jesus looked at verse 17. Jesus looked at him and said, Peter, blessed are you, Simon Barjona. Jesus called him his father's name, you know, the son of Judah. Simon, the son of Judah, Barjona. And he said, flesh and blood did not reveal this to you, but my Father who is in heaven. But if you read down, he said, and I will build my church, and the gates of hell, because he was standing in front of the gates of hell there, shall not prevail against it. And in verse 19, he said, and I will give unto you the keys of the kingdom of heaven. Ah, karabasotorobobo. And whatsoever you shall bind on earth will be bound in heaven, and what you loose on earth shall be loosed in heaven. So Jesus said, I will give you the keys. And many of us have been wondering, I've been worshiping God, serving God, what are these keys? What am I not doing right? If you look at Luke chapter 3, Lebraga Satarababa, number one key we are going to consider today is prayer. A lot of Christians, you know, their prayer life and their sinful life is almost the same thing. If you ask them, you know, how they have been keeping up by not, you know, sinning against God, many people rather will go down. And if you ask a Christian that goes to church, tongue speaking, even some pastors about their prayer life, which is intimacy with God, you see that it goes down. We start with prayer. Luke chapter 3, Lebraga Shakarabababa. The Bible says when everybody was being baptized, even Jesus also came to be baptized after the discussion with John the Baptist. But after everything, Jesus was allowed to go in. The Bible says when Jesus went in, Bakereba Shatarabababa, to be baptized in verse 21, Luke chapter 3, verse 21, he said, when all the people were baptized, it came to pass that Jesus also was baptized, and while he prayed, the heaven opened. Jesus began to pray. Everybody was being baptized as a religious thing, but Jesus was not settling with the norm. The normal thing is when you become a child of God, join a church, and they get baptized, wear white clothes, pay families come, you get certificate, there'll be celebration. But Jesus, you know, bypassed all that. He was not living in dogma. He went in and began to pray. And the Bible says, as he prayed, the heavens opened and God spoke that day. Lord, let me tell you something. Prayer is a great key They call it the master's key. You know, it doesn't open every door, but it opens most doors, because in prayer you communicate with God. In prayer you talk to God about everything that is going on in your life and what you have been able to do and what you cannot do. The communication with God is where you start. Prayer is a gift. So the Bible says, and when he prayed, the heavens opened. Many of you, as you begin to pray now, your heaven shall open. Number two, likarabasatra, because of time. Obedient. The Bible says that obedient, if you are disobedient to God, you will be stuck in the mud. But if you are obedient, the Bible said in Job 36, verse 11, he said, if they obey and serve him, they shall spend their days in prosperity and their years in pleasure. Go and obey God and you will see what will happen. Even in 1 Samuel chapter 15, when Saul disobeyed God, and Samuel started to talk to Saul, and he told him, said, to obey is better than to sacrifice. Number three, because of our time, number three is service. Exodus 23, verse 25 to 26. He said, you shall serve the Lord, and he shall what? Bless your wine. He shall bless your food, bless your drink. You shall serve the Lord your God. You must serve God. Serving God is not something that you think about. It's not an option. It is something that you must do as a Christian. The Bible says Jesus told them in the book of John chapter 8, verse 30, he prayed to the Jews and they believed in him. He said, as you have believed in me, continue in my word. Serve me. Continue in my word. Then you shall become my disciples indeed. And you shall know the truth, and the truth shall set you free. Another one is tithe. You know, when we talk about tithe, people think that we're talking about money. Tithe is when you fear God, you give God money. You don't honor somebody with your mouth. I see a lot of people say, I honor you, Bishop, I honor you. They see their pastor, they honor their father with their mouth. Father, I honor you, I love you, I honor you. When you honor somebody, you give them substance. When you honor God, you pay your tithe. Nobody will ask you for it. It's not something that people ask. It's something that you just do because you know that you are called to do it. In the name of Jesus Christ, let your eyes of understanding be enlightened. Let it be open. Let your eyes be open. Ephesians chapter 1:17, so that you will understand what we are talking about. I know that I've been able to tell you some few point prayers. We talked about prayer, obedience, service, and tithe. Pay your tithe. The Bible says Malachi chapter 3, verse 8. A lot of places in the Bible, I don't have to quote it for you, but go and pay your tithe and be blessed. My name again is Bishop Dr. Gabe Ezobele. Let us pray. Father, we thank you for your sons and your daughters. As many of them that will begin to obey and begin to pray and begin to serve you and begin to be tithers. Open the heavens and let their earth begin to bring forth.